In this video, I'll show you a super easy and fun method to create cartoon backgrounds in Inkscape, a technique I've been experimenting with lately. We'll take a real-life photo and turn it into a full cartoon background by following a few simple steps and rules I came up with. Later, you can take this further, mixing and matching different photos to build complex scenes. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. If you're new here, I upload weekly Inkscape tutorials focused on character design, background design, and game art. So if that sounds interesting, consider subscribing and hitting the bell. And if you want to really master Inkscape, I have a special bundle of 13 full courses covering everything from character design to full environments. All using Inkscape, of course. Link in the description. Your support helps me keep making free content like this. The first step, which should sound familiar if you follow the channel, is gathering references. But here it's extra important because our entire composition will be built around it. You can use any kind of picture, but I recommend sticking to non-copyrighted images, just in case. Sites like Pexels or Unsplash are great. They might have fewer options than Pinterest or Google, but the images are royalty-free, high quality, and more than enough to cover what you need. For this method, I suggest going for photos that include man-made structures, buildings, bridges, walls, etc. This technique involves tracing, and those objects are easier to simplify and stylize than a nature composition, since they have a clear perspective and all of that. Another great and underrated option is Google Maps. You can explore locations freely, rotate the camera and find interesting angles. Or if you are brave enough to go outside, another great option is to just grab your phone and take your own picture. That's probably the most flexible approach. For this video, I was looking for something castle-like. And I found this photo that immediately gave me some imposing tower or maybe a prison vibe. The original photo feels calm and neutral, but that's where we'll make use of our creativity to transform it into something more interesting. We are not done with references quite yet. The second step is to find cartoon references, and this part is really important. We need to translate the real photo, with tons of details, into a stylized cartoon which is much more simplified. To do that effectively, we need examples of how to simplify the elements we see in the photo. In this case, I don't know why, but the castle reminds me of the background art in Samurai Jack, the classic Genndy Tartakovsky series. So I gathered a few references from that show, including towers, cliffs, and castles, to guide how I simplify the shapes and forms. Having a cartoon reference as a guide is essential. It helps you resist the temptation to trace one-to-one. The cartoon reference acts as a filter, showing you what to keep, what to exaggerate, and what to ignore. Also, we probably won't want to make a one-to-one adaptation of the photo. It's always useful to have references to make some changes and draw some unique things. Once you start tracing, here are a few recommendations I can give you. You want to stick to the main theme of the original picture. Make use of the core idea behind it and the way it uses perspective and composition to show off that idea. In this case, I only cared about the castle. Everything else was up to change. You'll see how easy it becomes to reshape the composition once you have a main compositional idea. I turned what was originally a peaceful castle into something darker and more intimidating. Here are a couple of tips for this stage. Work in black and white first. You'll notice I'm using field shapes with outlines. Forget about the color for now, just focus on the design decisions and the silhouette. And here's another Inkscape specific tip. I have a free Inkscape starting pack, which includes, amongst other useful things, tons of ready-to-use vector assets. Bushes, trees, clouds. This can help you to quickly dress the scene without need to draw anything. It's also great for adding some finishing touches or to quickly experiment with the composition. Notice how different it looks now. It's practically a new concept. While tracing, it's easy to see what works and what doesn't, and make some adjustments on the fly. Here it was easy to simplify the architecture and adjusted the proportions and shapes to fit the Samurai Jack style. though it takes some effort to work within a show's limitations, like the flat shapes and the sharp silhouettes. Once you're happy with your drawing, it's time for color and lighting, and this part is usually the easiest if you have everything. Start by gathering at least one color reference, maybe from your cartoon examples, or something that fits the mood, and start sampling the colors. It's very likely you'll have to do some adjustments, rarely the colors will work out of the box, but at least you'll have a strong base. For my version, I went for strong contrast and those dramatic, full black shadows, typical of the backgrounds in Samurai Jack. A quick tip, take advantage that it's easier to make variations by duplicating your drawing and testing out different palettes, different illumination, times of day, or even atmospheres. I'm not gonna do that here because I already have a strong vision for what I want, but it's a tool worth keeping in mind. And remember the free asset pack I mentioned a minute ago? Well, it also includes over 170 vector textures to give your art that stylized texture look many cartoons use. You can download it from the link in the description. Anyway, this is gonna be useful to help imitate as much as possible the Samurai Jack style that has this heavy textured feel. And one final tip, if you really struggle with the compositions and the colors, or the rendering in general, I'll let you know the bundle I mentioned earlier has two full beginner courses on making backgrounds that go over all of this with much more detail. Again, link in the description. I won't lie, this method takes a bit of practice, but once you get used to it, it's a great place to start a new composition, and it doubles as a great practice for improving your overall background design and drawing skills. If you found this helpful, don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell. It really helps the channel grow. And tell me in the comments if you plan to try this method yourself. That's it for today. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye.